We want to determine the derivative of f of x equals x to the fifth times 7 raised to the power of x. So we need to recognize we have a product of two functions. So we'll have to apply the product rule, which is given here. So we'll let the first function equal f and the second function equal g. So our derivative is going to be equal to f times g prime plus g times f prime, where the first function times the derivative of the second function plus the second function times the derivative of the first function. So I always think it's helpful to write out the product rule before determining any derivative. So now we'll determine the derivative here and the derivative here. So f prime of x is going to be equal to x to the fifth times the derivative of 7 raised to the power of x. And again, just in case you need the review, here's the formula. And again, just in case you need the review, here's the formula. Since the exponent is x, we don't have to apply the chain rule. So notice the base is equal to a, so a is equal to 7. So our derivative is natural log a, or natural log 7, times a to the x, which is 7 to the power of x, plus 7 raised to the power of x times the derivative of x to the fifth, which is 5x to the fourth. So this is our derivative function. The rest is algebra. We want to be able to identify the greatest common factor of these two products. So notice how they both have 7 raised to the power of x as a factor, and they also both have 4 factors of x. So if we factor this out, let's see what's left. We would have one factor of x here as well as natural log 7. So we have x natural log 7 plus, we're factoring out the x to the seventh and all of the factors of x, so we're left with plus 5. So this would be our derivative function. In the next video, we'll look at a derivative that requires the quotient rule as well as the derivative of an exponential. We'll actually be determining the derivative of this function here.